Dipende da te, o visitatore, che io sia tomba o tesoro, che io parli o mi taccia, non entrare se non lo desideri.
What is resilience? Sorry.
Work with cinema, work with film, because I'm trying to work with this material like an architect, looking at the cinema like something that can be interesting for architects and for architecture.
Sometimes doing something poetic can become political, and sometimes doing something political can become poetic.
Don't take excuse of being from a poor country. It's only a poverty of mind that can prevent you from making decent and good architecture.
Che vuol dire preparare anche le persone al cambiamento e preparare le persone ai nuovi sfera, un progetto di cambiamento. È importantissimo che ci sia, perché questi progetti, perché il modo di lavorare sta cambiando.
It's a very big question. And we don't have a special formula. So yeah, it's a very interesting, challenging question. It's too early to tell, too early to say. But I guess you have to be optimistic.
The 23.
The power of storytelling is very important because it's another way to bring people and to dream all together around stories.
When you design a house, try to look a bit beyond the limits of the site.
The poetry for us, when we are engaged with poetry, is a way to really, we say that remove the floor. That means that the poetry give us the way to start, in this case, the practice of architecture, through different steps. If you go to the poetry, they are really in the origin of the things, in the words of the poet, is really goes deep in the most simple questions. What mean to live, what mean to control the lights, to control the environment as a way to live. These questions always are part of the poetry. That means that with relation with nature, with the relation with the places, with being here and now. And I think the most important thing, the relation with poetry, is this idea of listening the question that they ask to us.
Poi nella mia esperienza la cosa migliore è quando le persone diverse collaborano, perché se lasci architetti con architetti, mio Dio che noia. Artisti con artisti forse anche, artisti con architetti, con scienziati, con pensatori, con tecnici della foresta, del territorio, con ingegneri idraulici. Ecco che i lavori attecchiscono veramente alla realtà del territorio, anche specifica, anche tecnica.
What we see here is a paradigm that has no more than 10,000 years, and the paradigm is telling us that what we build is artificial. And what artificial means for us today is that it is not part of an ecologic process. It's not circular. So everything you see on the left, everything you see on the top of images, the buildings, they simply go to waste.
By saying no to this and yes to this sort of landscaped stripes or ribbons, if you want.
The main question is how we can design a human settlement for 10 billion people in the planet and at the same time be able to feed them with the primary resources and also secondary resources, which means living happily within 30-40 years. So we have a target, and the target is 10 billion people. Being able to develop a visionary utopia.
Quindi incertezza e rischio. Se non c'è incertezza, non c'è rischio. Ma tutti i fenomeni della vita reale sono affetti da grande incertezza.
You know, touch each other and socialize and be...
Well, you have a damage here, and you will see what happens to the nutrients and to the flows. They are going to move through the damage. So what leaves this type of multi-connectivity is extraordinarily resilient.
We need to start thinking that every object is part of a system, and every time we have to start checking how this injection, how this plug-in interfere or is linked to the general system.
Sometimes doing something useful can become useless, and sometimes doing something useless can become useful. Architecture should be useless. Useless to the market, useless to the destruction of our planet, and maybe architecture could be something other than just a commodity. Useful uselessness. Useful uselessness. Useful uselessness.
Un sito non vale niente se lo abbandoni.
The human being is characterized by openness. Man is formed by many forces. Two of them are the environment and architecture. Today, however, we have to recognize that there is a third force. It is big data. Database design and artificial intelligence intervene in the relationship between man and architecture language.
The point is that you have an endless variety based on the few rules.
Fare architettura in questo momento significa confrontarsi con infinite variabili, infiniti problemi che vanno, come dire, dalla certezza dell'esecuzione, la certezza della realizzazione accurata, la certezza anche dello sviluppo del progetto stesso.
Abbiamo avuto la paura del terrorismo dal 2001, poi la paura dell'immigrazione. Se avessimo pensato che a ognuna di queste crisi bisognava rispondere fisicamente, sì, la soluzione più banale era i muri contro i terroristi, i muri contro le invasioni dell'immigrazione, ma in realtà forse quello che andrebbe curato è più l'origine delle nostre insicurezze, delle nostre paure. Per questo anche nell'urbanistica ci siamo resi conto la sostanza dell'importanza dell'aspetto sociale, la creazione di reti di comunità.
Non esiste un'architettura senza una comunità di riferimento e quindi proprio per questo motivo, oltre a focalizzare evidentemente sui temi dell'architettura e sugli strumenti dell'architettura al nostro lavoro, altrettanto dobbiamo focalizzarlo per cercare di capire che cosa vuol dire questo binomio e magari anche orientare in qualche modo la nostra professionalità attraverso delle scelte anche libere di scegliere quale comunità, verso quali comunità, come dire, proporre anche il nostro lavoro.
Probably one of my two or three favorite buildings in the world, Santa Maria dei Miracoli in Venezia. This is a leaf, and this is the city of Évora in Portugal.
On the right, you have something which is built on what is called spandrels. Spandrels means redundancy on shape, elements. And every shape is done not necessarily with the scope. Every branch can go to a dead end, but the possibility to proliferate in different branches allow us to be resilient. This is, in my opinion, a diagram that represents the future of the city. It's a city that is programmed not for a use, but for a process able to embrace the possibility that there are mistakes in the system.
Occhio alla professione di architetto, è quello che dicevo prima, poi esce un eunuco tecnologico. se non vuoi limitarti a monumentalizzarli mettendoci il piedistallo, vengano gli uomini con le intenzioni guerresche, vengano a riprocessare questi potenziali.
As an architect you can think that you also can make and you can build.
Non c'è nulla di preconfezionato e predefinito, quindi poi i ricercatori si sono molto divertiti.
When the man discovered the fire was for sure not looking for the fire, but he was developing thoughts that somehow led him to find the fire. To do this revolution, our knowledge, our understanding of the environment will lead us to a step down, a step back from the idea of privilege that human people have about their role in the world.
Someone else wants to speak?
You are beautiful, guys. Let's take a screenshot.
Grazie, Giovanni. Grazie mille per
l'opportunità, grazie a tutti.
Assolutamente.
Una discussione.
Public space, urban planning,
Copernican revolution,
community,
meet people,
uselessness,
co-creation,
learning process,
not easy,
theory,
people,
helpful,
useful,
ecology,
activism,
revolution,
irony,
excitement,
aims,
needs,
freedom,
I trust you,
mix,
stop.
What is resilience? Sorry. Thank you.